Hi, which element is attracted the most to a magnet? Is it a clear winner, or is there any competition for it? I will test the best candidates at room temperature and an outsider just below that temperature in 4 different experiments. Going into this, I thought there would be a clear winner, but I was surprised by the results. Maybe you will be too. Strong magnets will bite you at any given chance. Do be careful with them. And wear safety glasses when using them. You'll see why later. Nickel and cobalt can cause skin problems, so don't wear them as jewelry. Overall, there are 3 ways a material can react to a magnet. Diamagnetic materials are weakly repelled by a magnet. Materials that are paramagnetic are weakly attracted to a magnet, but can't be magnets in themselves. And then there are the ferromagnetic materials, which are strongly attracted to a magnet and can be magnets in themselves. The ferromagnetic materials are what we call magnetic in everyday speech, so obviously we have to look for the strongest attractions in the ferromagnetic elements. There are only 3 of these: iron, nickel, and cobalt, at room temperature. If we go just below room temperature, gadolinium also turns ferromagnetic. Since just below room temperature is a normal temperature in Denmark, I consider gadolinium a ferromagnetic element and will include it in the tests. First test is the most obvious. Place samples of similar size on top of a powerful magnet and see how much force it takes to remove the samples from the magnet again. I will use this spring balance and zero it before each test so the weight of the container and sample doesn't count as pull force. I'll start with cobalt. This element is used in strong samarium cobalt magnets and cheaper alnico magnets. Seems like we can expect it to do well. I will measure at 2 spots, the center of the magnet and at the edge where the magnetic field is stronger. At the center, the pull force needed to remove the cobalt rod is around 1.4 kilograms. At the edge, the magnetic field curls hard down towards the other pole, making the rod switch position. With more of the rod close to the magnet and in a stronger magnetic field, the pull force will be much higher. Looks like 5.2 kilograms for cobalt. Not a bad start. Next up is nickel. It is used in the relatively weak alnico magnets and as coating on neodymium magnets, so I'm not expecting nickel to perform as well as cobalt. The pull force on the center is a mere 600 grams. On the edge, it's 1.4 kilograms, similar to cobalt on the weaker center. Let's switch to my favorite contender, iron. This element is the main part of the neodymium magnets, the strongest permanent magnets we know of, and also used in ferrite and alnico magnets. It should perform well. Oh yes, almost 2 kilograms on the center. It must be high on the edge then. It sure is. 6.3 kilograms is very impressive for a small 12 gram sample. How about the outsider gadolinium? It is not a main part of any commercial magnets. It can be used to make neodymium magnets more resistant to demagnetization, especially at higher temperatures, but dysprosium seems to be preferred for this. Here in my living room, gadolinium is only paramagnetic, but let me test it anyway. At the center, it doesn't align vertically with the magnetic field like the others, a sign of it not being magnetized like a ferromagnet. But for comparable results, I will measure it standing up like the others. 400 grams pull force, not bad for a paramagnetic material. Almost as good as the ferromagnetic nickel. It does surprisingly well at the edge too, 1.2 kilograms. Now I'm really curious to know how it performs in its ferromagnetic state. Depending on different sources, the transition should happen between 16 to 20 degrees Celsius. That's very convenient, because even in a warm winter, it is cold enough in my sunroom to turn gadolinium ferromagnetic. Let's see if it really works. Well, it clearly is a different reaction. Now it aligns vertically like the other ferromagnets. Isn't that amazing? The only difference is 10 degrees Celsius. Let's see how it performs. On the center, it has increased to 600 grams, the same as nickel. But on the edge, it is now almost 2 kilograms, better than nickel. The conclusion of the pull force test is that iron is the winner. Not a surprise. After all, it has Fe printed on it, the first two letters in ferromagnetism. Ferrum is Latin for iron, and ferromagnetism is named after iron. It is more surprising that gadolinium in its paramagnetic state is so close to the ferromagnetic nickel. Maybe my spring balance isn't precise enough at the low forces. Or is the gadolinium magnetized at room temperature? More testing is needed. I want to see how well the samples conduct the magnetic field from this tiny magnet. As a control test, I will try with 20 mm air first. Air does not conduct the magnetic field well. Only 3 millitesla. Time for a montage of the results of the ferromagnetic elements before we test gadolinium. Alright, they maxed out between 23 to 31 millitesla. Will gadolinium be any match for these values at room temperature? No, not at all. It isn't much better than air. It is not showing any ferromagnetic behavior. The ferromagnetic samples had a stronger magnetic field at the edge, a sign of them having poles like any other magnet. But I don't see it on gadolinium at this temperature. Will we see a change at 11 degrees Celsius? Yes, now it acts like a ferromagnet. It is as strongly magnetized as nickel and also show higher values at the edge like the others. Okay, so gadolinium was clearly not magnetized in the first pull force test. Maybe we should try with a much more sensitive scale. I used this milligram scale to measure the weight of the rods. It can be used for a different pull force test as well. By putting a magnet at a fixed distance above the rod, we can see on the scale how much the rod is lifted by the magnet. For nickel, it is 4.8 grams. Let me show you the others. Look out for an odd result. Again, we see nickel winning clearly over gadolinium at 23 degrees Celsius. But cobalt beat iron? Now I am confused. Is cobalt more attracted at a distance than iron? We need to include one of my favorite tests. The long distance test I call the water bath run. Working with ferromagnetic elements in this test for the first time, I wanted to get a feel for how long I could make the water bath. I didn't film it, but I wasn't exactly successful. The glass slipped out of my gloved hand. Do remember to wear safety goggles when working with powerful magnets. Here's the final setup. Will cobalt beat iron again? Cobalt wins again, followed strongly by nickel, leaving iron only to beat gadolinium. The results from the distance tests baffle me. I cannot explain why iron is the strongest at the surface of the magnets, but at distance, cobalt seems to have the highest magnetic susceptibility. Any help and input from you in the comments is more than welcome. The final conclusion on my experiments is a bit messy. At room temperature, iron is attracted the most to a magnet. The surface of the magnet. At a distance, cobalt seems to be attracted the most to a magnet. If we look at all temperatures, holmium is actually the strongest known elemental ferromagnet. However, it has to be cooled down below 20 Kelvin. My house is not prepared for handling the liquid helium needed to cool it. Yet. A big thanks to all my patrons. I'm glad to see the support from more and more of you. If you want to help me keep going with the videos too, then check out my Patreon page. Link is under the video. I bought several elements in the same size, so subscribe and click the bell if you are interested in seeing more elements being tested in a future video. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.